Retard. It's a word you would have heard me use a lot to describe my thoughts on a rotten situation. Like that attack on Iraq, that lacked any facts. So I sat back and said, now that is a retarded altercation. I didn't use the word as a way to demean or be seen as being hateful. Only to let you know you ate your weight in stupid and you still got a plateful. So it was okay. It was playful. But I didn't realize tied to the other side of that word was a slur and people cried when they heard it. I was oblivious to the insidious nature of the term. But I was about to learn it. So when my wife gave birth, there was no plan to rehearse for the worst, no test for this lesson. I was stressed and confused. I cried at the news. This ain't the son that I guessed I was getting. He's ailing and sick. He's thin as a stick. He's too frail to even come home. They said he'd be slow. Success would be low. And oh, he's got Down syndrome. And that's when it all changed. And I became estranged from that word you heard me use a lot. My son was the one who rearranged the plot. He taught me words aren't afterthoughts. They're weapons, they're used for good or not. So I got to build him an armored heart so this word won't tear my sons apart. But I don't know where or how to start. And that right there is the hardest part. Because I know I can't protect him. So I expect when he roams this world alone, he'll find this word under every stone. He'll flip it over and bring it home. And go over it with a fine-tooth comb. And he'll examine all the ways it's said, the nouns, the verbs, the adjectives. But I hope at night when he goes to bed, this word won't stay inside his head. Instead, I hope he dreams of this scene in France where he sees the word and they exchange a glance. He extends his hand and he takes a chance and he asks the word, would you like to dance? And they prance and play all day and get dirty, spread their wings and sing like a birdie. And then he tells the word, I know that it's early, but you got to go. Now that I know you can't hurt me. And then he goes and he shows the world what we see. A heart so big you'd hardly believe me. And though I know it won't be that easy, he'll break these labels so he's able to breathe freely.